don't get burnt. Don't get burnt. The fire there of the Calgary Flames.
Whew.
Finally smolders the Dallas Stars. And with that shot count and the way the Flames played tonight, it felt like a kicking. But for quite a while there, you have to give the Stars a ton of credit because Calgary was falling into the Stars game again. Jake Oettinger stands on his head. Does Johnny Gaudreau finally show up? He got some points today. What does Coach Ryan D think about the Calgary Flames, their effort this game, and the Dallas Stars? Let's talk about it. First things first, I love all the comments that we get through here, but I got to throw one up on the screen. I love when people rush to get the typical, hey, this aged well. I'm not chirping back at you at it. I love any fun you want to have here on this channel, but I think we should talk about it, not because of the comment, but because of what the comment sparks. And what it sparks is we don't look at games in small sample sizes with anything but the playoffs. We always look at giant averages because everything always comes back to the middle. Trends, patterns, how are people playing? What are people doing? But the playoffs is a time for pressure cooker. You only have 7 games max, 4 wins or 4 losses to strut your stuff and do your thing. Your window is this small and there are no excuses because if you lose, what are you going to do? Cry about it? So for the first few games in this series, Johnny Gaudreau on the top line for the Flames was basically invisible thanks to a stifling Dallas defense. Dallas is an excellent team at getting you to play their game and suckering you into the muck, as I like to call it. They just drag you into the muck and it becomes very hard to move. It becomes very hard to produce. And when you have a goalie like Jake Oettinger, 6'5" stud in net, standing on his head like he has this series, it becomes very apparent that you can get stuck in that muck for 4 games. But the Calgary Flames come out on this one 4-1, and they didn't just come out on this one 4-1 as like, okay, they got through it. No, they dominated, absolutely dominated from bell to bell. This was the Flames that I have been watching all year long. I haven't seen them up till now, and now they're here. So, yes, we want to talk about long sample sizes. Yes, the last video we got on Gaudreau in the first line. Yes, it was still valid. Yes, it was pertinent there. But today, because it's a small sample size, now we get to go forward. This channel is for very pragmatic, reasonable coaching, player analysis. This isn't a channel to be in a safety bubble, and this isn't a channel that just repeats what happened in history. So if that's you, the hockey guy's out there for that, and he's freaking fantastic. That's the kind of channel you'd be looking for. But if you're a hockey nut like me and you want that in-depth analysis, I think there's room for both of us, even though he's the absolute juggernaut and the GOAT. He's the GOAT for sure. So Flames dominate, but the Dallas Stars fans are sitting there going, Coach, you see those first 2 periods? What are you watching? Well, I am. I did. And I'm going to talk about it. And I'm going to give you your credit, Stars fans, on this one. You didn't do anything. I didn't do anything. We're just fans. We just watch. But I'll give Dallas the credit. And as fans, you can relish in that credit, because that's the best part about sports. I do it all the time with my team, too. But first, give Coach Ryan D a big thumbs up if you're new to the channel. Subscribe if you haven't been here before, or you have been thinking of it, maybe in your head. Maybe this is the time. It's free. Hit it down below. Subscribe to me. That's the button talking to you in that gross, creepy voice. Very much like George Costanza, sometimes I just can't get out of your head. And if you want to talk to Coach Ryan D, head over to the Discord. That is the place that we hang out. Stars fans, Flames fans, you know we're sponsored by BetUS as well. So it's all over hockey. It's the big thing. These apps, they're out there. If you want to switch over to it or give it a shot, look, I'm running multiples of them too. We see Gretzky talking about MGM. They're all over the place. 125% deposit bonus, free money coming at you to smash a couple bets if you're over the age of majority in your province or state on your favorite team. All proceeds go to help this channel. Stars fans, credit time. Credit time in the fact that you were able to draw them into the muck. Credit that you were able to survive 1 billion shots. Well, actually, it was 39 with 1 goal. 1 goal in 39, and that's the Stars game. I'm not going to say as a hockey fan that's what I want to watch, but I'm not going to tell you as a hockey coach that it isn't super effective, and that isn't what the Stars should be doing in order to win this series. So it's 2-2. There's 3 games left. I think Calgary has all the momentum in the world because they won this one. But if I'm the Dallas Stars and you told me at the beginning of this series, playing one of the NHL's best and biggest juggernauts, especially with scoring, that I could be in a 2-2 series tie with three games to go, I would take that all day, baby. So the Stars have done their job. The work's not over yet, though. They're going to have to find a way to solve Jacob Markstrom. Jacob Markstrom's been brilliant. He's a brilliant goaltender. He's absolutely just fantastic. We talk a lot about Jake Oettinger. I think Oettinger's outplaying Markstrom because he is literally absolutely standing on his head. But Markstrom and Oettinger, I've said it, don't take too much offense to it, Flames fans. It's goalie one and it's goalie two in the playoffs. I've seen every goalie play now, and right now in this small sample size, in this tiny window, they are playing the best. There's no question about it. They are solid. They are doing what needs to be done for their team. It's a results-based business, baby, and that's your job, and they have gone to work, lunch pails, and hard hats. As far as the rest of the Dallas Stars, unfortunately, they were unable to sneak something through Mr. Lunch Pail, Mr. Hard Hat, Jacob Markstrom tonight. They have to score on less shots than the Calgary Flames, but 35 shots is still a lot of shots, especially against team defense like the Calgary Flames. They're very good at playing team defense, but it looks like they let some of that go tonight for those 54 shots that they ended up putting in. And why wouldn't you? You haven't been able to beat this guy. When he's a big goaltender like that, you got to get through it. Finally, it takes a power play where Rasmus Anderson just gets through it. And Anderson's a freaking good defenseman. I really love what's on the back end of Calgary there. Thank goodness it comes from Matthew Tkachuk. He ends up on the board. There you go, Tkachuk. And top titty, I mean, Tyler Toffoli ends up cracking in there. So that's a nice, you know, breaking of the well. And you can basically just picture this. Imagine hitting a dam with a ball peen hammer. That's what I feel like the Calgary Flames. Just ball peen hammer against concrete all day, every day. But you hit that concrete long enough, eventually it cracks. Everything starts flooding through and you start scoring. And I think this may be that moment. Sideways dog head tilt, because I can't predict the future on it. The Stars could come out, drag them right into the muck again next game, and they could find themselves down 3-2. But my gut feeling after watching this game and this performance is that maybe they've cracked the well. We'll have to see how Jake Oettinger responds next game. We'll have to see if they're in his head, but he's a big boy, big body in net. I don't think he's got a ton of pressure on him, to be honest, win, lose, or draw. I think his team's pretty pumped with what he's done. So I believe he should rebound, but I also equally believe the dam will crack. Hey, look, I'm hedging my bets. I'm not going to sit here and tell you it's going to happen one way or another. The series has been too damn close, but I think you have an argument on both sides of the coin if you sit on one side or the other. Johnny Gaudreau then gets a penalty shot. All right, let's talk about Gaudreau. I ripped on him last time. I don't know if I've changed my opinion yet, to be honest. Gaudreau is a top three player. Results-based business. No forgiveness. McDavid's on fire. Matthews is on fire. Sidney Crosby is absolutely the GOAT of this playoffs. He's the GOAT of every playoffs. He is the man right now coming off of that game. So if you want to enter greatness, if you want to enter the annals of history, and if you want to be an elite player, he'll get his money. It's coming. You're going to get paid. That's done deal. You don't have a season like you had and not get paid. Someone's going to bank on it in the terms of the 10 million or north number. No question about that. But we're here for more than that. And he's here for more than that. He has something to prove. And what I saw from Gaudreau today was a lot more jam. I saw a guy trying to get to the net. And it's not that he wasn't trying last game. I've never said it's an effort thing. I'm saying he's a little guy. He's a small guy. They hit him. They hook him. They pull him. They get him off his game. And you know what? Tough kid. You got to find a way to get through it. You're 100 pounds soaking wet with rocks in your pocket. Nobody cares. Your job is to score and lead this team on the score sheet. That is your role. That's what you're paid money to do. And that's what you have to figure out how to do in the playoffs when everybody's being really mean to you. So, did he play better today? Absolutely. Has he played terrible these playoffs? No, but has he played terrible in the sense that you expect this guy to lead one of the best teams in the NHL? Yeah, he has. Has this turned it around? Let's hope so. Let's hope this is what he needed to crack on through, and that penalty shot brought him the confidence that he needed, because I'm going to keep coming back to it. I watched him have, like you, no more, no less than at least three elite chances. There was a crossbar slash post in there. There was a splitting the D moment in there. He was doing Gaudreau things, and Ottinger stoned him. And then a penalty shot happened, and he laid him out beautifully. Wasn't that gorgeous how he got it through? And you might say he's back, but I want you to remember something. There was no hooking him. There was no holding him. There was no defender on him. So as soon as the physical stuff goes away, Captain Johnny Hockey seems to show up. The physical stuff comes in, and he misses the net. Or Ottinger saves it. Or the puck doesn't go in. So this is a good confidence booster. But what I am looking for from Gaudreau is I'm looking for Mr. 100-point two-way player elite. Take the bull by the horns, the stallion if it's the Calgary Flames. Set that bitch on fire. Ram it down Green Street and put pucks in the net. That's what I'm looking for. So did he have a good game? Absolutely. Will his teammates high-five him? Should everybody feel better about it? You should. Now we got to build. Now we got to go forward. We need more. We need more. It's a results-based business. That's your role on this team, and everybody has a job to do. So like Bill Belichick used to say, just do your job. And when your job is to be the best, you can't settle for anything less. Elias Lindholm ends up cracking in the third goal there from, hey, Johnny Gaudreau. So that's a nice two-point night there. And Noah Hanifin. He's still the most underrated defenseman in Canada. When you look at all the Canadian teams, I love Morgan Riley, but Noah Hanifin is one of the most underrated D guys in Canada. He may be one of the most underrated D guys in the West, but it's pretty tough when you're in a Western conference that houses the likes of Cale Makar and Roman Josi and a whole bunch of other elite players. But Noah Hanifin is excellent. Rasmus Anderson is excellent. This team is stacked top to bottom, so they're finally getting through their crack in the code. Mikael Backlund and Callie Yarncrook end up showing up at the end because they get an empty netter. Surprise, surprise, it's Ty Lewis. A lot of empty netters are bumping up the goals here, but that's been these playoffs. I've really, really enjoyed them. A couple key things to note, because we're not going to break down a bunch of goals here, but I love going over to TSN.com because we want to talk about the dominance of this game. You need to see how damn good Calgary was. I know you saw it with your eye test, but let's just reinforce it. And then you can see how damn good Dallas was and Jake Ottinger was at stopping pucks. Look at this shot count. That is danger, danger, Will Robinson, if I've ever seen it. We love drawing our home plate. Look at all those chances in those spots. That is absolutely scary. Calgary was penetrating the middle like it was their job, right down Green Street, like I said, with that bitch of a stallion on fire. You move over to Dallas. Look, Markstrom, he had to make some big saves in this game. 35 shots, yes, most of them are from the outside, but there were still enough shots in the middle for Dallas to be able to do damage and take this game home. I love going over to Natural Stat Trick because when you look at the shot count, you get a visual of it, you start feeling it. We've done the eye test, we've watched the game, we know how we feel. You had my commentary, you see the shots and you're going, okay, I see what he's talking about. I see what I'm feeling. So then we end up scrolling down over here, and what you see in the blue here is just sheer Flames dominance. When you take a look at scoring chances, they had 38 scoring chances. That's incredible. 20 were high danger chances. Taking a look at Dallas, it was only 7 high danger chances versus 17 scoring shots. Totally different type of game. Corsi is probably the most important stat in my opinion in hockey. You can't look at one stat alone, but this is pretty close to it. Corsi is 66% for Calgary. That means they dominated this game in terms of chances towards the net versus chances against theirs. And their expected goals were 3.9. The other big thing to look at is, even though they're in a 2-2 series tie, after 4 games, when we go here and sort all the playoff teams by Corsi, they've all played four games. The Calgary Flames, the best team in the playoffs. They have absolutely done what needs to be done from a team standpoint. The only thing they weren't doing was putting pucks in the net. That's why we were hard on Gaudreau. You got one job. There's one line. There are key players that need to score. We talk about team scoring. Look, your first line is supposed to put in 30 to 50% of your team's offense. Your second line is supposed to jump in and put in somewhere between 20 and 30% of your team's offense. And then you're supposed to get a tiny bump from your third line, and the fourth line is nothing but bonus goals. Most of your offense needs to drive through your top six. That's the thing you got to take away. So yes, it's a team game, but when you have a first line like this, they have one job and one job only, and that is to beat the line they're matched up against and put up more points than they are. Tonight, job accomplished. The other thing to look at is the shots percentage. So if you're not really a Corsi guy for the Calgary Flames, we can sort this by shots for, shots against. So we just use the classic shots for 97, shots against 69. Well, they're still the best. They're getting the most amount of shots for versus the most amount of shots against. And it's unique because in the regular season, we talked about this, they didn't get a ton of shots for, but their team defense was incredible. So now they are finding a way to adapt. And I love that by Daryl Sutter, changing the game when things don't work. That's the sign of a great coach. They're no slouches either when it comes to high danger chances. Look, Pittsburgh is absolutely destroyed and lit up the New York Rangers, but the Calgary Flames are number four. So what does it tell you? They're the best team in terms of putting pucks on the net, but they're not the best team in terms of percentage at getting those high danger chances. And that's why they're not converting as many goals as we'd think they would be. So tons of chances on net are great, but they got to be the high danger chances. If you're unable to get the high danger chances, you got to tip your hat to the Dallas Stars for being able to limit those, even though it's an absolute shooting gallery out there. That is design. That is a system by the Dallas Stars. The question is can this system hold for another two wins? And that's going to be really hard to tell. I still think this is Calgary all day. I think this is muck they got to fight through. The Colorado Avalanche, as Daryl Sutter said, I love Sutter, they got a bye basically by beating Nashville. So Flames fans, you let me know what you think down below. I appreciate you being here. Stars fans, I appreciate the comments you guys have here. All the times you remind me you made it to the Cup Final, you let me know your roster, you let me know everybody that's down there. Hey, we're not writing off the Stars, but the Flames are just quite the juggernaut. It's been quite a while since Calgary's had any success. Dallas, you've had a ton of success in the playoffs. It's been your time. You got the Cowboys down there. You got the Rangers. There's lots of good things going on. Let Calgary have this one. I know, I'm from Winnipeg. They got the Flames. We got the Jets. And that's it. So this is a pretty big deal for the people of Calgary, the city of Calgary. I'm not saying lay down and die. I'm just saying give us a break. This is what we got. All right. Thanks for being here. Catch you in the next one.